We'll do a circle of protection.
Girl, we can get
circle shoes.
We can get the lanterns.
Yes.
You were the one that was scared.
There is normally a rule, this is what they call physical mediumship.
Can you be spreading
this? And they used to
Jack Sparrow running, please.
They used to do this in the Victorian era, in the age of
spirituals. Yeah, they kind of do, don't they?
Where they would directly communicate with the other side using physical objects. So, you want to tell them about that? Sort of you talk about that?
Oh, yeah, sure.
The thing was that, and as we do as ghost hunters now, we want some sort of proof that there is something more than what we think exists. Yeah, and you know, our great great grandparents thought the same thing. You know, they wanted to see something physical so that they could believe in something. Because the churches at that point in time really weren't doing anything. There was literally only one power, and that was the power of God. And who ruled the power on earth? The priests. Yep. Beyond that, there was nothing to question. So you didn't ask questions, you just literally followed the rules, you followed what the church has told you, and you didn't ask anything else. So they can't get any of that match.
I know.
Don't
get you ones.
So there was a big movement that occurred with the seance stuff that started, because people were going to war, they were dying, they weren't coming back, and it's not like, you know, you've got news for the day now. Mobile phones that are telling you what's going on. A son would go to war and a mother wouldn't know what had happened. She wouldn't get a letter back, or she wouldn't know at all for months and months. And if she did find out that her son had passed, for example, which, you know, it's like this unfinished business. Well, how did it happen? Where is he? Where's his body? How did it all happen? And so there was this sense of never knowing enough information. Never having closure. And so with people would call a medium in, and a medium would do a sitting, and a medium would try and communicate that communication level. But the whole table tipping thing started because of this raising of energy that they were doing, creating this circle of power and creating an energy for that could move something like an inanimate object, right? And of course the medium would be sitting there and the table would tilt or move, and the medium could say, see, your son is here with us. Can you see how he's moving the table? Can you feel his energy? And so for a mother to be sitting there visually feeling and sensing energy moving would give her that real sense that, yeah, her son has not come back, he's here for this particular moment. And the closure that she required to move on. And so this became rip-roaringly popular. It was happening everywhere around the world, certainly in Australia as well. And there were big people that were really in favour of this. So you had people like Arthur Conan Doyle, who was writing all the books. The members of Parliament in England formed the Society of Psychical Research. And a lot of people were really getting into this as a method of communication and a method of connection. And yeah, you didn't need a medium. You know, mediums cost money. You could, all you needed is a table, and you needed enough people around the table that could get together and have this seance. And seance only means a meeting. That's all it means, a meeting. We are meeting, I guess, between the worlds. We're forming that connection between the worlds energetically. So table tipping was sort of the first thing that was created. And this is all about trying to make this table tilt. That sense of, I hope it's not going to be loud. But what we are trying to achieve for people who are at the table is the feeling of the energy that is being produced. And to show you how powerful we are and how we can, if we get together and focus and create an intention, how things can really magically happen. Right? So it expands, it literally expands our brain, and our brain will go, oh my God, that's possible, or what else is possible?
We're so a battery.
We are using a table we've never used before. That's number one. Number two, we have people here who have never done this before. So we're kind of going to crack the cherry, first of all, with some people who, first of all, have the intention of belief more than anything else. We can't have skeptical people up here or people who are deeply fearful. Because it will just make the process harder, and what we need to do to begin with is to start to get activity, start to get movement. Once we can start to get movement, we will opt people out and different people can come in. That shouldn't be an issue, but I guess we've just got to see how it works. Yeah? So we should see how it works. Now what we need to do in the interim, can some lights go down?
Yeah.
Do you want me to hold it?
Yeah. So can everyone see the base of the... So let's just all, to begin with and to open the session, because we like to open and close the session, if I can get you all just to close your eyes for a moment. And just settle yourselves into your seats. Take a breath in and out. And we are officially going to open this silent session. And we're going to ask our guides and our team on the other side, and our loved ones that are on the other side, and those that look after us spiritually on the other side, to also come into this circle tonight. Thank you. And we're going to put the intention out that with the deepest of respect and the deepest of love, we ask the spirits that are here with us tonight, whether they be the spirits of the jail or whether they be the spirits that have come with everyone tonight, to be willing and open to make a connection. And to make this connection something really physically real, we are going to ask those spirits that are joining us tonight to help us activate this table so that under our fingers it will move, it will tilt, it will twist, it might walk, to show the power that we have in creating energy and making energy here and connecting with the spirit world. So if you have any fear, if you have any doubt, just push that to the side. Push that to the side just for the next half hour or so. Engage. And let's work with the sense that we can achieve this. So I'm going to ask three people to come and join us at the table that will be ready to have a go. What three people would like to come? Me?
Yep. I'm going to play some music in the background, so don't forget about the first one.
So what you need to do is to have your hands completely on the table, very, very gently.
And your hands as well?
Let's see how it works. Let's see what happens. So there's a connection with the table. it's on, no pressure. And we are guiding our energy into the table itself. Remember, the table itself is energy as well. So it will change under our fingers. It will become a little bit more malleable. It will no longer really feel like just wood. It may vibrate a bit. Or it may feel as though your fingers are actually going through the table. Call in the spirits, and we're going to ask them to tilt this table for us, please.
The best of this is the circle. If we can just imagine that we have energy that's coming in through the top of our head, and coming out through our heart, going out to. We're going to send it to Renata because she is the medium on the table. So we send her the energy, and she will wink the other people on the table. Activate.
Calling in the spirits, asking them to join us at the table now, please. Bring your energy forward. We ask that you help us tilt, twist this table under our fingers. It's okay to reposition your fingers if you so wish. Just remember a light touch, all that's required. Come on, bring your energy forward. Asking the spirits here to move the table under our fingers. Well, we know it's a new table, we know it's a new place. Come and assist, come and help. Come and tilt this table, please. Twist it, lift a leg. If you prefer to knock on the table, you can do that. Anything you wish to do to show your presence. Sometimes what we feel, first of all, are the legs on the bottom just shifting a little bit as if they're lifting up off the floor a bit. Those here at the table, just if you can focus your mind on the spirit team, those that are helping and assisting, just ask them in your mind to lift the table and twist the table first. It's riveting watching, isn't it? It's riveting. Shows how smart you are. Shows how we can work together.
Sorry, my ass is in your face over there.
I didn't know.
Oh, it's sliding.